So this is the second part. Here first I'll talk about the drawing template and drawing views. And to do this, go to new, drawing. Now here also you have used default template. Uncheck it and say OK. Now here also you can see that I have my own CADx template here in this list in two different sizes. So whenever I go for new, say drawing and use default template and say OK, I get my CADx template by default. When I say OK, my template opens like this. So for drawing also you can create your own template and you can set as default. And to understand the complete procedure to create drawing template and set as the default template into that list, there is a separate video. The link will be given in the description area and it will come onto your screen. You can watch this video to understand the complete procedure. So once you have added your own template to your drawing, now the next task is to create drawing views. And to create drawing views, go to general view, say OK, place here, say front, apply. And OK. I'll change this scale to 1.5. Now go for projection view. Select this view and project it to this side. Now when you create your drawing, there are two different places where you have the scale. One is this place and another one is here, this scale. To change your drawing scale, you should not use this custom scale. From here also you can make it 1 and say OK. But this is the wrong procedure. This scale is only for additional views created in Creo Parametric. So suppose you are creating detailed view, auxiliary view or any other views, then that scale will be used. For drawing scale, this is the scale. You can make it 2, you can make it 1 or you can make it whichever scale you want. So once the base view is added, now the next thing is you need to add the center axis. And to add center axis, go to annotate, show model annotation, go for last tab and select the views. Now you see, when I click this view, I'm getting my center axis for pitch circle die automatically. One more time, go for show model annotation and this time you select this view. Now go back to your part and switch on your datum. Select this datum plane, go to view, section, make it A, say OK, save it, close it, switch off the datum. Now double click this view, go for sections, 2D section plus, select this section and apply it. This item, you can double click and go for spacing. You can make it double or half, whichever you want. So done. Go back to your part. Just hide this cosmetic sketch. And this area is gone. Now when we talk about view creation, there are different views here. Projection view, create all the projections. Like this or like this. Then you have detailed view, auxiliary view, revolved view. For revolved view, I have a separate dedicated video. The link will be given in the description area and it will come onto your screen. You can tap the link and watch the video. For auxiliary view, I have a separate part. So this is the part. So whenever you have a part like this, where you have an inclined portion, then you need auxiliary view to show the inclined details in your drawing. So to create the auxiliary view, first place your drawing views. So if you create a projection view, it will come like this. Now in this case, you cannot highlight these details in any of these views. So in such cases, auxiliary view is the better option. Click on auxiliary view, select this inclined line. And project it somewhere here. So now this view is parallel to the sketch, so you can easily add all the details. So this was the auxiliary view. And to create detail view, just click on detail view, select a center point and just start sketching the spline. Do not cross your spline, just keep some distance and press middle mouse button to say enter and click anywhere in your drawing. So this is your detail view. Now if you want to show these edges a nice curve, then first you draw a sketch like this. You can position it wherever you want and then you go for detail view, select the center point and then while sketching the spline, follow this path. Just like this. Again, do not cross, just press middle mouse button and say enter. Click this side. Now go back to sketch and select the sketch and delete it. Now you see how nicely you are getting the curve. So this way you can create the smooth curve for your detail view. But for this drawing, I don't need detail view, so I will just delete it. So this was the projection view, detail view, auxiliary view and revolve view. Now to get this PCD automatically, I have a separate dedicated video. The link will be given in the description area and it will come onto your screen. You can watch this video to understand the complete procedure. So the drawing views are over. Now let's talk about the dimensioning and DTL file. So to create dimension in Creo Parametric, there are two different ways. You can go to the annotate and you can add all dimensions manually here, just like this. Or you can call all the model driven dimension from feature by feature using show model annotation. From here, you can even go for this option and select each feature one by one. Now you can select all the dimensions from here and you can deselect some of the dimensions. Let's make this scale 1. Similarly, one more time, go for this feature, select all the dimension and deselect this dimension, apply. Then this feature, select this dimension, apply. Then this hole. Now this hole, you can go by this view. And you can rearrange later on. Similarly, you can go to this pattern and select show model annotation. Now here you can go for note and select this note and say apply. Now this note, you will see the use of this note in coming session. Now go for this cosmetic and select this note. So again, this thread note is model driven. I am not creating this manually. I can just select it and I can reposition it. Go for this chamfer, select the dimension and select it. Then this round. Select this dimension and say apply. So you have added all your dimension. Now the cleaning part. So go to the dimension. Select the entire dimension at a time. Right click, say clean up dimensions. Now here just say apply and close it. Go to layout, select this view and move it. Now you have this piece circle center axis automatically and this is the piece circle dia. Now some of the dimensions I will move from this view to that view, and to move use this option, move to view, to this view. Similarly, this dimension also I will move to this view. Now this dimension is not required since I have this model driven node. Now rearrange these dimensions. Now let's first correct this node. So this is M42, just double click this. But it is coming with 3 decimal place, so remove the 3 decimal place. Now here, just put big bracket 0.0 and click outside. That 3 decimal place is gone. Similarly, once again click here, and this time for this position, big bracket 0.0, or it is having 1 decimal place, so 0.1, big bracket close, click outside, 4.5 h external. Now this value is 1.5, so to change it you need to go to the part, go to this cosmetic sketch, properties, and here you make it 1.5 and say okay. Go to the drawing, and now it is 1.5. Now you have H external, here it is 6G, once again you click here. Now the last portion you completely remove. Now here you put one dash and type 6G. And your note is done as per this note. Now this dimension is missing, so go back to your part. Here edit this pattern, and this time you remove this, and this one make it 60 degrees, and say okay. Save it, go to the drawing. Once again, select this, show model annotation, and now you have this dimension. Select this, apply, and cancel. Now here I am going to use this symbol to make this dimension parametric, and for this I will go to tools, switch dimension. Now this symbol is P40. So what I will do is I will click on this dimension, and here I will add ampersand P40, put one space X, and that's it. Now the same thing I will do with this dimension, ampersand P40 space X space, and enter. Now if you change this to 8 numbers and this to 45 and say okay. If you go back to the drawing, you see it is 8 numbers 45. So this is the use of this note. Now I'll delete it. Now here I will change it to 6, and this is to 60 degrees, and I'll save it. Now if you see this dimension, this is into the box. So to put any dimension inside the box, select the dimension, go to the tolerance, and make it basic. Now if you go for this dimension and try to make it basic, only 60 degrees is coming into the box, but here the whole item is inside the box. Select it and make it nominal. And once again select this dimension, go to dimension text, and here you write at the rate big box, and you see the whole item is coming into the box. You close it with at the rate big bracket. Say okay. So this is how you can put all the items inside the box. So now I have covered this area. The only part left is the GD&T. So GD&T part, I will come into the third part. Now this area. Now if you see this dimension is having limit tolerance. So select this dimension, go to tolerance and select limit. Now change the limit value, make it 6 and make it 4. This you make 1 decimal and say okay. Similarly, this dimension is having symmetric tolerance. So go for symmetry, move it this side, make it 1 decimal place, and this you make it 0.1. Now if you go for this dimension, again this is limit tolerance. So go for limit, change for 1 decimal place and set the limit. So this was the dimensioning. Now let's talk about the DTL file. So when you create a drawing, you do lot of settings, like my drawing is having number of settings. Now see, the text are coming bold, the arrowhead is filled, and when I create a detail view, I get ASME 94 circle, ASME 94 circle, this circle. If you create, you may get this circle, circle like this. So these all are the settings related to the DTL file. Once you do all the settings in one drawing and save those settings as a DTL file to use those bunch of settings at a time to all your drawing. So once you add the template, the first task before adding the views, say I am creating a drawing. The first task before adding the views is go to file, prepare, drawing properties, change, and here you call your DTL file. So here I have CADx DTL, I will select it, apply it and close it. So all the settings which I am getting currently here in this drawing will get in that drawing. So this is the use of DTL file. So the DTL file includes 100 of drawing related settings. It includes angle of projection. It includes detail view scale factor. It includes the detail view boundary type. It includes your arrow length, width, so many things. Your font, which type of font you want, arrow style, and so many things. So once you do all these settings in any of your drawing, you can go to file, prepare, drawing properties, change, and these settings you can directly save it as your DTL file. You can add your own file name like drawing DTL and say okay. So once you save that, you can anytime call that DTL file using the same procedure. You see, drawing detail. I can select this and I can apply it. And that detail will be applied to any of your drawing. So this is the detail file. You can do endless setting related to your drawing based on your requirement and save it as your detail file, and you can call this detail file whenever you create a new drawing. So this was the second part related to the drawing template, the drawing views, the dimensioning and the detail file. Now in third part, I will talk about the GD&T in detail. So let's move to the third part.